Hi there, this is Wensley, and today I'm going to try and draw a demon gale with wings. I'm just going to draw the head, a rough idea of the head, and maybe draw some arms. Get these arms and they're enough sorted out, because I don't want them to be too big, but and I don't know what I'm gonna try and aim for here. I don't know, maybe bring this arm round. Sort this arm out as well. Maybe change that arm actually. Draw some rough ideas of the hands maybe. Do the same with this. Going to be demon hands. I want to quickly mark in the wings. Don't want them to be too big, so I'm aiming for it like a manga style, you know, where they have short wings. So I'll just try and get that other wing in there, maybe just sketch it in draft, you know, like a draft little sketch for now, because it doesn't have to be perfect or, you know, anything, as long as you've got the main elements there, you know, that arm's looking okay. I'm not sure about this arm, but we'll come back to it. Let's try and sort this head out now. Give her some hair, maybe decide where the hair's gonna fall. A bit of a cheeky ear sticking out there. Sort the face out. Try and make the eyes slightly dark. Some of the hair in like that. Don't want the demon girl to have like a pretty face, but the body is going to be like a contrast where it's almost perfect sort of thing. Draw a bit of tit now. Nice one. Sorry, that was a bit of a childish laugh, wasn't it? Never mind. I do apologise. Sort all this out now. Just try and give it some sort of shape. And if you have to extend the arm, it's best to do that. Slightly pronounced there. Let's leave our eyes like that. Erase them pencil lines. Back in the hair last. I want to work on a bit more of the body. As I said, just try and make the drawing as best you can look okay. again, I'm still not happy with that arm. It doesn't look right. So I'll come back to that bit last. Maybe I'll raise it and try again. I'm happy with this arm. It's got, you know, it's got a bit of shape to it. So come back and I'll try and get these wings sorted. Behind the hand, you can probably see. Yeah, we'll put it roughly there and maybe sort this hand out. When drawing any drawings, you'll always come up against, you know, like a lack of planning or something, or mistakes. You think you've got the right, you know, sort of shape of things. You know, one side looks alright and then the other side don't look quite like, you know, right. So you can always rework, you know, certain areas, you know, because there's no need to worry about it. It's just one of them things we're drawing. You know, sometimes you just want to rush into the drawing and, you know, you make sort of like small design mistakes like that, which will sort out quite soon, that bit. So we've got the face, you know, we've got the wings near enough sorted. This part sorted here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to lightly suggest where I want the shading, you know, to fall. Be shading under there as well. Just like bits of shading on the head. This is just a guide, just to help me when I come to colour it after I've inked. I can, you know, just decide where certain areas will be coloured and, you know, things like that. Just a bit of shading under that bit there. Some shadow there. So I'll just erase them when it comes to it. I know where the shadow is going to be on this demon creature. So, you know. Let's just even out this tit. eye in a circle, which I forgot to do. Darken up the lines on these teeth now. Come back to it. So really we've just got us to sort this arm out, which is as you look back on it, it doesn't exactly look right. So what we'll do, I'll just find me a razor, if I can find it in this untidy place. So as you can see, I've erased that, which is left a rough guide, because we want it to go in that same position but look like it's more attached. So what we do is like we look on there for the shoulder there and see how far it goes, and on the other side we do that. Work out the shoulder and mainly like bunch the arm so it looks more like it's attached. Go with the flow of the muscle movement as well, and hopefully it should look a bit more like it's attached to, you know, the arm. Maybe do it like that. So we've got near enough. Better arm. Yeah, I'm going to change this and maybe do the arm or the hand downwards like that. A rough hand there, which again could change there, but got the other hand there and that hand there. Actually, that hand will change because it looks slightly bigger. Bit of difficulties with this one. So I want this hand to maybe look like it's reaching out. Maybe just doesn't have to be perfect. It's only a drawing. Didn't work out. A few first attempts, then just work at it. You know, just try and roughly draft that sketch in. You know, because I wanted that hand to mainly try and look like it's, you know, more forward than that hand. Even though they're at the same level, but you can redraw things if things don't work out. So thing about drawing. Art is what you make it. So I think we'll leave it at that stage. You know, we've got the basic lines and everything that we want to sort out. That heel goes behind there anyway. The foot comes out there. Maybe just more slight areas of shading which where we want. You know. That's basically it. I mean, it's not bad for a demon girl type drawing, or demon woman with wings, you know. But we can work on this drawing, maybe improve that hand when it comes to the inking stage, you know. So yeah, it's an idea. Right, so here we are inking this demonic winged creature woman thing. I've got a Bayroll fan liner ink pen, which I've been using more of quite lately, because some of the gel ink pens have just started to clog for some unknown reason. It's mainly due to the paper type and the pencils on the paper. So I started using these and they're a lot better. So I'm just going over some of the pencil lines, maybe try and make her hair look more greasy looking really. Work on his eyes, you know, straighten them up, you know, to sort of improve the drawing. So on that side, just to be nice and even. She's got sort of a double chin under there. That was intentional. Eyebrows in, thicken some of these eyelashes around there. Some of these teeth, making them stand out slightly. Finish the hair. You notice that pencil line there will be rubbed out once I, you know, start to colour. Change slight bits of the hair, maybe add in a few other curls and straggles of this greasy looking hair. Maybe do the same on the other side. There, just to fill out the hair a bit, make it look a little bit better. Maybe do a little frown line in there. Just add that. Maybe that one like that. And so we want to improve it. I mean, notice these wings, this on this side is slightly smaller than that wing. That's intentional because this wing is supposed to be on like an angle. So that was intentional. So start inking over these wings now. I want these wings to be black, I'd say, totally black wings. We can work on some more detail there. Improve the lines. Follow through there. And we've got the lines coming down here. Just go there. Add a bit more detail to, you know, your drawing, you know, as you go along with it. There just to help, you know, show the muscle. A bit goes there. Maybe that's all you want to do because it's like a demonic. Just finish dry inking them collarbones. Maybe just do a little line underneath there. Do this shoulder. Do that armpit under there. Start on these titties. There, the heel will actually be there because that'll make her foot quite quite small compared to that one, so that'd carry on up there, so it'd be, the heel will be there. So we can maybe sketch in them right at the end. So we'll just carry on. I mean, I remember I was worried about this hand looking slightly bigger than that one, but then I thought, you know, she was a demon, then maybe she could make her hands bigger by somewhere. So we'll do some movement lines on that hand to make it look like it's transformed or something, which is usually a good save from, you know, drawing or making a few mistakes here and there. And there we can maybe draw some movement lines, like it's probably grown, transformed. And then when it comes to the colouring stage, you'd probably do like some kind of colour around that, just to, you know, maybe emphasize there's some kind of power there or something like that. So we'll finish this wing off in here. Some of this. I wanted the wings to be darker anyway. Just add other details now. We're doing the other side as well. I suppose you could say the devil's in the details. Yeah. If you wanted to, maybe draw just a couple of lines, you know, just to make it look like the wings are flapping, something like that. They always help, just to add a bit of stuff to it. So yeah, right now we'll just do some small bits of cross hatching just to emphasize a bit of shadow. Too overboard with it. You just want to help show where there's a bit of shadow, and it'll help when it comes to colouring it as well. So, you know, do some of this area. I mean, you don't have to do small bits like this, you could just leave it, but I like to do shadowed areas. So coming back to these feet now, you don't have to go too mad, you know, because that's, it's just a suggestion of a foot there and on there as well. The main focus is on this area, so yeah, I'd say that's done. I'll just do me signature, because sometimes I just forget. And then we'll just rub out the pencil lines and then we'll start to colour it. So there it is. Cheers now. Hi there, this is Wayne Tully, and today we're going to colour this demon woman with wings. I've got some Crayola Twistables here, so we're going to give it some nice cool colours. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off by using the black, and maybe just lightly shade outside the wings on the outside. So I think on the wings, gonna be like a purpley red, I think. So we're going to get that purple and start to colour into the inside of the wings. Leave some like white areas, I think that's important. I'll try not to colour over the hair. I'll just get some of that the inside area of the wings to be, this like purple colour, maybe bits of purple behind there as well. We'll mix some reds in there as well. finish off the inside of this wing. So we shaded it like that. We'll come back to that. I just want some maybe like cool blue colours to suggest this, you know, demon, you know, creature. Obviously past that shaded line, and on that shaded line there'll be a definite change of shadow there. Blue on there. I'm going to try and make this sort of purplish, possibly. Around it all. Some of this side of this blue. Blue on that area. And we can start to mix in a bit of, you know, purples here, just to really suggest shadow. The idea is to try and blend it in with, you know, the blue. Feet and the hands to be more purple in colour, more redder too. And then there's also, you know, shading as well. Like the purple colour, certain undertones. And just try and blend the purples in where you think the shadowed areas will fall under. And always remember the tone and the shapes of the arms as well, and try and aim for giving that some kind of 3D effect by either curving the shading or, you know, adding bits here and there. And just start to add the purples to the, you know, the fingers there. I'm not quite sure what quality the fingernails, I don't know. Possibly leave them white, I don't know. Shade it from the opposite angle, just to fill in the gaps in your drawing, you know. This is always the case when adding shading, you can accentuate the form and the, you know, the figure more with colour, so you can just, you know, build up a series of tones. And these cool colours are just helping make this, you know, more cool. And we'll leave like the bit in the middle, so it just creates a highlight area. It's always important. I think for this, you know, demon, we shall give her red hair just to help give it a nice contrasting colour. Just blend in the eyes there. Really. To add this purple. So I missed the ear, but I'll come back to that. So really you can start to add these red hair. I think it looks quite effective adding red hair to this demon. Although I'm trying to keep to like really cool colours, so I'm still trying to leave in some like highlights, you know, like white areas, which will just help. And I said on this, I wanted just to add in some, you know, red on the wings. I think that's still important, because it adds a nice level of tone to the inner wing. It helps separate it from the rest of the body as well. thread as well. To make them totally red. And then I'll just give like a yellow for the eyes. Make them eyes stand out as well. And I'll just add some purple. Yeah. Purple around the nipples. Nice one. And there's some blue on the ears there. And that's pretty much it really. I said I wanted just to add some red just to the fingers, just to, I think it's always important to try and blend some tones together. And you can work on a drawing as long or as short a time as you want. But for me, I'd like to move on to the next drawing. I'm always moving on. Got to really draw as many things as you can. I'd leave the teeth like that. If I wanted to, I could put like red in the mouth of the area if you wanted to, just to help separate them teeth. And that's pretty much it. If you just wanted to show that this is like the hands getting larger, you know, some transforming type of hand, you just put a suggestion of some kind of power or something occurring, movement lands there, so you could just probably do that. And that's it really. I hope you enjoyed that little colouring tutorial, and I hope you understand that it's not necessary to colour in every white bit of the paper. Sometimes it's just best to leave subtle bits, you know, like white areas as like highlights in between, you know. As always, you can scan this in into the computer and work on it digitally, so it's entirely up to you. But there's another concept. So I hope you enjoyed it. Cheers now!